One of my favorite parts about being a computational scientist is that I can work on such a diverse set of problems. And for me, I feel like I have the expertise and the tool sets to address problems from energy all the way to medicine. And that's really exciting to me. My name is Kayla Sprenger. I'm an assistant professor in the Chemical and Biological Engineering Department. I lead the Rationally Designed Immunotherapeutics and Interfaces, or RDI, lab here at CU Boulder. In a lot of these cases, we're, as computational scientists, plagued by the same type of energy barriers, the same type of challenges to actually simulating these processes. And so in this respect, we can really learn from one field how we can better use our computational tools to address problems on the other side, whether that be the energy to the bio or the bio to the energy side. So one major area of my lab is designing HIV vaccines. And a key way in which we do this is starting by modeling the biological processes that go on in our bodies, for example, describing how antibodies evolve against a given pathogen. And my lab has developed the first sequence level model where we can actually see real amino acid sequences of antibodies evolving against real sequences of pathogens. And the idea here is the space for designing the sequences is actually extremely large. And so this is where machine learning really comes in and helps us to steer towards the optimal protein sequences that would actually go into an HIV vaccine. I've had a long-standing interest in working on problems that lie at the intersection between physics, chemistry, and biology, but my work in the energy sphere really began here at CU, and it was really spurred and inspired by the work of my colleagues here at CU. A major challenge right now is dealing with mixed plastic waste streams, which are comprised of multiple different types of plastics. In this area, my lab is really looking to understand the molecular scale interactions that occur between these polymers and these mixed plastic waste streams and the catalysts that aim to break them down and upcycle them into more valuable fuels and chemicals. I've seen that it really will lead to new ideas in a given field. When you're exposed to ideas in a related, but you know, slightly different application, it really encourages my students to think more broadly, right? Think of solutions that other people in the field haven't been able to think about because they haven't been exposed to these different perspectives on science.